In this lesson, you will learn how to use your customized functions on Excel worksheets. Functions that you create in VBA can be used in the Excel workbook environment. In this worksheet, cell B2 contains the value of 0, which is the initial velocity of a projectile. Cell B3 contains the value -9.81, which is the gravitational acceleration on Earth, and cell B4 contains the value 2, which is the time since the projectile was fired. If we want to calculate the velocity of the projectile in the vertical direction, we can go to cell B6 and type equals B2 plus B3 times B4 and hit enter. We can also make a function in VBA that will do the exact same task. Here I've created a function procedure named vel that has 3 arguments, v0, g, and t. The value of v0 plus g times t will be assigned to vel. After this function procedure is terminated, the value of vel will be returned to the cell on the worksheet where vel is invoked. The function vel can be used on any cell in the workbook. I click on B7 and type equals vel B2, B3, B4, and hit enter. And we see that we obtain the same result as before. The value of B2 in the workbook, which is 0, is passed to v0 in the function vel. The second argument is the value of B3, which is -9.81, and this is passed to the second argument in vel, which is called g. The third argument is the value of B4, which is 2, and this is passed to t in vel. v0 plus g times t gives us -19.62. It's important to remember to type the arguments in the correct order. If we accidentally type equals vel B4, B2, B3, and hit enter, we get a different answer than before. This is because the value of cell B4, which is 2, is passed to the first argument in vel, which is called v0. The second argument is the value of B2, which is 0, and this gets passed to the second argument in vel, which is called g. The third argument has the value of B3, which is -9.81, and this gets passed to the third argument in vel, which is called t. v0 plus g times t is 2 plus 0 times -9.81, which gives 2. Notice that no error message appears because nothing is technically wrong in the function, but the function did not give us the answer that we wanted. In addition to using cell references as arguments, we could also use numbers and cell names. Let's give the name v0 to cell B2. And in cell A7, I'll type equals vel v0, -9.81, B4. When we hit enter, we again get -19.62. The value of the cell v0, which is the value stored in B2, which is 0, is passed to v0 in vel. The second argument is negative 9.81, and this gets passed to G in vel. Lastly, the value in cell B4, which is 2, gets passed to T in vel.